So I think everyone is in this room. This room looks quite crowded. I have to say, I totally expected this to happen because it's an interesting topic that concerns nearly every living being with a digestive tract. It concerns sloths maybe once in a week. It may concern you a bit more often. And so there is a secret war zone. A secret war zone in every flat, in every household, with at least two people living in, that's concerning the tree bit of the toilet seat and toilet top. So there are some people who consider one valid state and people who consider three valid states for this. And we hope to get some improvements by technology from this, from Tobias with the internet of the toilet. Toilets, please, a big round of applause for Tobias.
Thank you. Can everybody hear me on the back, on the sides? Is that good? Yeah, thank you. Before I start, you might see that sign, and I want you to leave the room if you don't want to hear what I'm going to say. So I might use some words that are not to be streamed into every country, so just be prepared. And also, I need a volunteer, because there are some slides. There's somebody already. I would like to read you, to let you read some of the slides. So if you're confident with English speaking, and I'm a German speaker by nature, it's just a sentence, and yeah. That would be cool if you could read out some of the slides, and Alex the Herald will hand you the microphone. So is there any native English speaker or anyone who wants to volunteer? Please give a hand. There's one. Yeah. Hey, you can stay where you are, that's fine. You can come on stage if you want, but that's fine. So there will be, there will be slides by Nibbler, which is a cat, and just read them out when they appear. That's it, and then I continue, and then it comes back again, and then. Do you have a mic already? Okay, we wait.
We'll take care about this and stand by your co-presenter until she gets a mic.
Thank you. Okay, then I'm going to start. I will take questions at the end, so if you have anything to say, anything to ask, just keep it and give it to me after. Let's rush to the slides. I hope I can manage the time. Welcome. So this is Internet of Toilets. Trends in the sanitarian territory, and there's my Twitter handle if you want to contact me. And there are some hashtags, so Internet of Things also uses IoT, so I suggest using shit happens in addition. Regarding the structure of the talk, I'm going to present a chronological list of examples. It's just a selection, though there's much more, but I couldn't fit it in. And those are all first world problems. So there are personal installations, but there are also commercial examples. And it just shows what people have done, and I just go through without commenting on them. And yeah, my personal motivation for this research was quite similar to what Tony Piscali wrote in August 2014. I'm gonna read that out. At the office, when nature calls, there's an arduous uphill both ways and often snow-covered track to the bathroom area. The bathrooms are also out of sight for everyone in the office. Many times someone will turn the corner to the bathroom and see that they are all occupied. The person now must either wait around until a bathroom opens up or go back to their desk. and try it later. Try again later. I also experienced that many, many times and was very frustrating to me. And I couldn't see the bathroom from my desk, and but I also saw many colleagues failing all over the time. So I decided that's the time to do some research and find ways to overcome that. So the first example is a smart bathroom, and this is was posted as a tutorial by Michael Szczepanski and Chris Cheney. And I don't have a date for this one, but it fits quite similar to the last, to the motivation I mentioned. And Michael wrote, my friend Chris and I, who sat in view of the bathroom, cringe when seeing failing attempts and people hoping to relieve themselves. Why someone we somehow joked that an indicator could help our coworkers. So what they did, they installed an airplane heads up and an area of the toilet, and then everyone could see that. And they also created a web application that shows the status of the toilet. And there's source code, you can check that out, it's on GitHub. I just want to keep it short, but interesting, they found some results already, so they could calculate the all over time, and managers don't like that. And they also discovered that there's a high activity at 3 a.m. for what reason? And they found false positives. So when somebody shuts the door, but nobody's in, so they still have to work on that. They couldn't find out yet whether this generates longer or shorter waiting times. So there might be coming a new blog post. By the way, all the posts, I've given the URLs, and I try to shorten them to tiny URL. And there's really a lot of information. All the tutorials have steps, and they have codes and everything, hardware. That's your task.
Night poops. 32 grams of poop were deposited by Nibbler. She weighs a svelte 4.75 kilograms. Nibbler was done in 101 seconds.
Next up is an installation of the MIT. That was created in 2001, and they have a status web page which shows all the vacancies of the bathrooms. And I contacted them, and Daniel Ziegler wrote me that no one knows if it's still working and how it works, and every now and then it dies. But there's actually a problem with the kitchen site, so it's marked with a K. They all have the same time, so somebody would have look up. And they have Christmas time, as you can see, the bathrooms is quite free now. It's like 4 days old, the picture. They also have a laundry server, which shows the status lights of the washing machines. And they have an email service for that. So I tried that out and got an email when the washing machine of somebody was done. You can try that out. There are some pictures. He sent me some pictures of the installation. So that's like the best technology they could get. And there are some wired cables. And I think the server is pretty up to date. So. If you're interested in meeting those guys, they're actually here. And there's a lightning talk called Secure Public Key Distribution System. So if you want to see them, I think you can find them.
Breakfast poop. Nibbler deposited 46 grams of poop. Her weight is 4.75 kilograms. Nibbler spent 29 seconds pooping.
Yeah, thank you. And the next example is a gamification idea. It's called Urine Control. It's from 2002, and it's an installation of a urinal, and has electronics, a microcontroller, and a custom video game. And the idea is that the user aims jumping hamsters, and there's a corresponding panel in the urinal which targets the hamster. So, and you could see the game on the screen above, as you could see on the picture. And the idea is that the hamster then, when you hit it, turns yellow and gets screaming and spins around, and you get 10 points. And so that's the panel, and it's inside the urinal. And then there's a custom input controller, which is a rubber nozzle. Attached with a water reservoir, so you just put it to your body as shown there, and then you're gonna play it. And I mean, it's a game, but there are benefits. So there's improved sanitation. You are very confident in doing what you do, and there's proper hydration, so you go regularly, and maybe there's increased beverage sales in the area around where you can play that. And for children, you can do potty training, maybe, and yeah, there's entertainment. So.
Nibbler stood at the edge of the abyss, but the abyss was silent. She left after 52 seconds to clean herself.
Thank you. The internet loophole browser was a post published by Andrew Kubert in 2003, and the idea is to search the internet while you're on the toilet, and so you could print out web pages and on your toilet roll. And actually, I could just discover this picture and the text you see. I couldn't find out any more, so if you're interested and want to see if you can find more, I found that on an old website in Internet Archive. Yeah, let me know. And Microsoft also published the ILU on their website back in 2003 on the 2nd of May. And there were speculations about whether Microsoft is going to build an ILU which allows to use the toilet and the internet. And I want to quote what was written there. The world's first internet outhouse or ILU, complete with broadband access and the first WWWC. Windows XP powered computer, 6 channels round audio, a flat screen plasma display, waterproof wireless keyboard. MSN. MSN UK is negotiating the toilet paper manufacturers for special roles with web addresses and URLs printed on them. Yeah, this is another one from Great Britain, and this is from 2004. You have to know the museums have free admission, and this was introduced in 2004. And so the Science Museum in London is a large building with 7 levels, and there are 3 million visitors per year. And they have a high electricity costs. And so the museum director, John Tucker, came up with the idea that they could actually use what people leave behind, which is poo. And so they could put that into a mini power plant or a microbial fuel cell or something like that and turn it into electricity. And so they calculated that the excrements of 100,000 visitors would power up to 500 light bulbs. I can't say if this was realized. I wrote them an email like half a month ago, but it's still pending. I didn't get an answer. I don't know. Anyone knows? Okay.
Did you know a Tesla Model S weighs 438 times as much as Nibbler?
Next up, a project by Gregory Lavoie from 2007. And this is a tutorial posted on instructables.com with almost 200,000 views, 550 favorites, and over 300 comments. He describes how to mount a sink on top of the water tank of the toilet. And this allows you to minimize the water consumption. So anytime you use the toilet, you wash hands, hopefully. And then why not using the water which you use for flushing afterwards? And he said anyone could build that, and there are expensive models out there, but he's tried to build something that is from parts that can be recycled. And so if you buy this there's a large range of models, and I found stuff for $140 up to $1,600 for a toilet. And people adapted the idea, and I picked some of the implementations from the comments, and they're really beautiful. And people came up with different stuff, and I'm pretty sure you can do this on your own.
Poop time. But there was no poop forthcoming. Nibbler weighs a svelte 4.85 kilograms. She was on the box for 60 seconds.
This is from Brazil. Shit happens, similar to the Twitter tag, if you remember, but with an H. And those guys send a message every time somebody goes to the bathroom, and what they used is a Arduino board combined with an infrared proximity sensor, so they could actually see when somebody is there. And it's a large tutorial. It has all the code, and if you're interested, visit the website.
Did you know, based on the past day, if Nibbler lives to be 16 years old, she'll have spent about 11 days on the litter box over her lifetime?
Twitch Shitters is a project from March 2009, and it actually shows how you can scale the idea of the sensors, which I mentioned before, to multiple stores. And it's installed on the Kinanet, which is an internet conference in Israel.
Fact of the day. If reacted with anti-kitty poop and converted to electricity, Nibbler's daily poops could power China for 4 hours.
Mike's toilet is from 2009, and last activity is from 2013. So some of the Twitter accounts I mentioned are no longer used. And Mike was interested in how many times he's using the toilet and how many gallons of water he's using. And there's an installation online, and he uses an ultrasonic sensor, which has a distance measurement capability, so you could actually see if somebody is standing or sitting. And the whole installation is $30. I got that. And yeah, there are some posts of the Twitter account.
Poop fact. The weight of Nibbler's daily poop output in pennies is worth 48 cents.
The Heck Lab Toilet in Toronto, Canada is also a Twitter account, and it was created in 2009. But the last activity dates back to 2009. I don't know what's going on there. Actually, the blog post went offline while I was researching, so I got some facts, like you can see, but it went away. And yeah, there's a list of hardware you can see. So I show you some pictures which I saved before it went online, offline. So there's a debugging on the left side and the installation, all the wires. And they have many ideas for future improvement on their blog post. I recommend reading that. It's very interesting. Just one idea is to put RFID to identify the person who goes there.
Poop waits for no cat. Nibbler completed a nice bowel movement of 34 grams. Her weight is 4.87 kilograms. Nibbler spent about 2 minutes pooping.
Seabase Space Station Berlin. I guess there are some guys here. And there's an installation which is there since 2012 in the hackerspace. And actually, this is a result of a discussion about a controversial image on the cabin door. So they installed a door switch on the which you can see there, so the cable goes to the whole hackerspace, and that was connected to an old computer, and then there was a renovation going on these days. So actually, it's not working right now, and Twitter also changed the API. So the last activity is back from 2014, and thanks to UK and Jacek for the insights.
Poop alert, 21 grams of poop were deposited by Nibbler. She currently weighs 4.88 kilograms. Nibbler spent about half a minute pooping.
Internet of Toilets. This is a project of Thomas Rücker, and the Twitter account is IO Toilets. And this is pretty new, from 2014, and he got a broad audience, I guess. There was a coverage on Slashdot. He was laid off work, and then on the weekend after he was bored or something, and then he just built an installation on his toilet which tracks the water consumption. And yeah, if you follow that, you get tweets like that every day. I got them. And it just shows the amount of water, and it's really interesting.
Cat facts. Studies show that Nibbler poops her own weight every 56 days.
Next up is Paul Reisinger. He posted an instruction which is very similar to what Thomas Rücker did, but he also tracks the toilet paper holder. So there's a photocell in the spindle, and when he takes it off, he could actually see that the toilet paper was changed, so he could track that. But that's just the beginning. I really found those comments very, very interesting. There are people posting so many ideas how to improve that, count the paper slices and measure the diameter and whatever. You have to read that.
Clearing the pipes for dinner. Nibbler pushed, but only 6 grams came out. She weighs 4.68 kilograms, mostly fur. About half a minute was spent.
There are also business cases. So in London, they recently installed smart loose at the Heathrow terminal too. If you're gonna fly around there, then they track you. So they count the number of people to actually see how much they are used, and then they send alerts to the cleaning personnel. And so they analyze how often they are used, and then they try to find out if those in the one corner of the terminal are used, or if they have to put more or make the signs better or whatever. And this also raises privacy issues, since they track how long cleaning personnel needs or how long it takes to go there. So that's another fact. Another Britain example is the biobus, which runs on poop. And it takes passengers from Bristol Airport to the town of Bath. And and it generates the power from biomethane. And yeah, the person's annual waste could help for 37 miles, they calculated, of one person.
Fact of the day. If reacted with anti-kitty poop and converted to electricity, Nibbler's daily poops could power Canada for 39 hours.
Thank you. So if we're talking about toilets, we have to talk about the state of the art. And this is actually from Japan. They have very high technology toilets. And I just read out some of the features they provide. So there's smell extraction, a blow dryer, seat heating, massage options, water jet adjustments, automatic lid opening, automatic flushing, wireless control, heated seat, room heating, air conditioning, the option to automatically shut down the bidet when somebody gets up. And also to change the amount of water which is used to flush if somebody is sitting or standing. Another thing to mention is medical analyzers. So there are ideas and also some prototypes to analyze what people put into the toilet. So you could analyze blood sugar and urine, pulse, blood pressure, body fat, viscosity of the stool, or occult blood. But but there are problems with technology, and I found one article of a Japanese leading manufacturer called Toto, and that was from 2006 and 7, and they had three times fire in toilets. That might be the heating module, and in 26 cases, smoke emissions. And so they had to offer a free repair for 180,000 bidets. And and there's Lixil, a very, very large company worldwide, which sells toilets by the product name Cetis. And there's an Android application called My Cetis, which allows to control the unit. But there's a Bluetooth problem. They hard-coded the PIN. Could anyone guess what the PIN is? I think I already heard it. Yeah, it's 4x0. So the scenarios that come up is what people could do. They could repeatedly flush the toilet, raising the water consumption. They could increase the cost. They could open the lid and close it. and then they could activate the bidet functions or the air dry functions, and that probably causes discomfort or distress for the user. Just two examples, but I'm pretty sure there's more. I'd like to thank you. If you want to know more about Nibbler, there's a Nibbler account. It's a nice idea to follow, and you get all the facts. And if you're interested, you can read more. Let me summarize. We talked about water consumption, so when, how much, how often, the sink on the water tank. We talked about toilet paper usage. I mentioned if it's empty, you can calculate the amount, the replacement forecast, or you can track the occupancy, if it's taken free, even the time somebody stays on the toilet. I didn't talk about audio. There's somebody who records the flushing sound with Shazam, and you can do that with farts or create user profiles. I didn't talk about the gas analysis, warnings, identification, automatic ventilation. You could try to neutralize it or burn it. I talked about comfort improvements, customization ideas. There are design ideas I didn't mention. So you could have a flush design of a tornado, which was mentioned in the article by Der Spiegel. And yeah, we heard about animals. There are train toilets. It's in everyday's life. There are airport toilets. I mentioned that. You can generate power. And yeah, medical effects, hacks, security problems. But I don't want to go off stage without mentioning that there is a World Toilet Day, and which is on the 19th of November. And that's a serious problem, because there are really a lot of people without access to toilets. And yeah, so what I mentioned are first world problems, but there are people who really have problems. And yeah, I'm now free to take your questions. Thank you.
That was an enlightening talk. We are running a bit out of time, though. We may only have time for one short, very, very pressing question. I think you on the microphone too were first to show up, so it's your chance.
Oh, thank you. I just wonder if you know about the research done in the 90s on the privacy problems concerning the data of people linked to the time they were in the toilet, because some enterprising people used those to determine if a woman going often to the toilet was pregnant way before maternity protection kicked in, and so the business could lay them off. So there is a lot of problems with the data, and I just wanted to remind everybody that it can be abused quite badly.
Thank you. I actually didn't find that one. With what I read about the medic facts, there's actually a lot of stuff you could analyze from the urine and or even like frequencies. Yeah, I didn't know this one, and there's really a lot of this, and I can share what I found. It's just a selection which fits in 30 minutes.
I'm very sorry that we can't take any more questions, because we're running out of time. It was a very, very interesting talk, but you can contact Tobias later, and please a big round of applause for Tobias.